that break. And you know what? Zalanda was right there giving you nothing but the amazing, amazing music. And you know what? We're having on the red seat. So keep the conversations going on all our social media platforms. And that is at Face TV Uganda, Corey the Horse, Zalanda. Go ahead, keep the hashtag on. It is The Backyard with Corey. And of course, that song, Kwano Go. Definitely, you must tell me. Just tell us a little bit about this song, the inspiration. Why did you choose Willie Nwaje and all that? How was it like working with her?
I thank you for actually asking about that. Mukwano Go, I give thanks for the song. Mukwano Go, actually didn't know it was going to make rounds as much as it did. Fact that how we made it, actually, it was something like not serious. We came from our opening place. Now with Big Nash, we started playing a beat. Because we used to create together from scratch. So we start making a beat, and we had a melody. But we didn't know the words to use. So basically, I was thinking, something like that, because it was love and all that. But the word Mukwano Go actually somehow won the argument and decided, we said, maybe we can make it for everyone. May not be for Muchala only, because even the guys
can use it.
Even the ladies will use it. So basically we said, let's use Mukwano Go. So I voiced the whole song, because we did a remix with Nwaje. But before we did the remix, I had an original version. And the original version actually was really dope. They liked
Actually, I don't know if you saw the views though, but
they liked it. The management liked it, and they were like, let's do this one right away. I was like, we don't have a problem with it. So we did, we shot. Actually, Marvin Musoke was given the task to do it. So I looked for the location. I got my friend. Big up on himself, Butcher, Nan, Dennis. We used his home, because we used only one location. And his home was quite a fancy home. So he accepted, and his dad. So we used his home to make the original video. And before even the original video was out, Winnie listened to the song. We used to be with each other so much, chill and this. So she liked it. She was like, "Yo, man, you guy, why can't I jump on this?" I'm like, "I don't have a problem if your management accepts." So I think she talked to them, and they actually told me to write her a verse, which I did that very, very afternoon. And I sent it to her on WhatsApp, and she was like, "Oh, this is what I'm gonna do."
How long does it take you to write a song, yo?
If the vibe is there, it could take a few hours. If there's no vibe, it could take weeks.
I know the connection has to be there.
It has to be right. The flow, you know how it is, man. When the vibe is right, it's right. And if it's not right, that's why they call it a mental block. There's something they call it, writer's block, in our whatever game. So that wasn't there, thankfully. So I did have the verse, and she jumped on it in studio. She came at night, and she put her verse, and she really sounds good. So she sounded good on the verse, and we shared the hook, and Ziga Fix was contacted to make the video. He's the one actually who looked for the place, and we did it from Freedom Beach in Tebe.
The song
was
given fire.
Back
hot fire to,
give back to
honestly,
the song.
Honestly, we love it. We play
and
it a lot.
It's a classic, I thank God, because anyone can relate to watching it. Be it now, be it tomorrow, be it after 10 years.
My crew, Rahis and Omar, were actually, you know, singing over it over again. I was preparing for this, by the way.
I actually just found out that it has just become viral on TikTok just a while ago.
You see?
Can you imagine? So stuff happens.
That's why they say do good music and make sure the music leaves a stamp.
So, I mean, how does that even happen? The fact that I don't know how TikTok even operates, I'm like, wow.
Oh, come on. You better jump on. You had better.
I'm on, by the way, but I'm just baffled by everything that goes on. I'm seeing challenges after challenges. It has like over 400 challenges. I'm like, yo, what's up?
Well, Zalanda, trust me, most of your music is good, is great. Wow. But I've gotten to realize you've done so many great collaborations. Yeah. So let's first dive in there a little bit. You know, with all the individuals, all the great stars you've worked with, who has been your easiest, hardest? How has it been like working with them? Are we expecting any more collaborations?
Sure. Big up to all those that I've done collaborations with. We're just starting. Yeah. By all means, man, because I believe it all has one journey all the way up. We're going international, global, because this music is not only for our locals or for us, or only we need to share it with the world. I did actually some songs back then.
Yeah.
I did a collab with Monji and Winnie, but people didn't actually get to know it.
For real?
Can you imagine? Yeah. It was called City Tava. It was some ambition mission thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, and after that, we dived in more collaborations. I think I've done with a writer called Black Skin.
Yeah.
Yeah, a song called Undercover.
Yeah.
Yeah, basically, we're planning to work. Before the COVID came through, we were having a tour in Schengen countries. And we were collecting, because when Eliza came through, we connected with the Tanzanian industry, and we're going to like go to Wasafi over and do some collabs with the likes of Mboso and also whatever other chick, the new chick in Wasafi, Zuchu. Yeah.
By the way, you're only getting that on the Red Seat, exclusive.
Exactly. And it's just a matter of time, and you guys are going to see the collabs happening, because I think now the industry is a bit free. We can breathe and we can move. Yeah. The airports are back open.
Yeah.
And the moves are going to go through still, but more collaborations are coming through with Zulanda. I may just jump on a verse, or they might just jump on a verse, but sure. Watch the space.
Yeah.
That's what I can say.
So we're having an EP or an album?
First, we're having an EP before the album.
Okay.
But on the website, there's quite some new, fresh, unreleased music that people can go and get you're familiar with.
Yeah.
The website is zulandamusic.com.
Okay.
Yeah. So you can see something that is going to come from there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, Zulanda, you've been in the industry for a very long time. How many years should we count in?
I'm starting to sing. I started in 2016.
Yeah.
Like my first release was Hey Baby. But as a writer, I've been around for 2010. Yeah, as a writer, I actually started writing in 2011. Like
so let's just say you've been in the industry for a very long time.
Yeah, I've been back since, but I've been looking out.
Yeah.
Singing 2016 is like now five
so
years.
I must say you're seeing what's happening now. Attestations are becoming attestations.
Oh my God.
Are you in any?
Yeah,
are you planning to set up a writers association too? You know?
I'm in actually Uganda Songwriters Association.
Okay.
And I'm also in the Uganda Musicians Association.
Uh-huh.
I've heard about these superstars or hitmakers, but I don't really think they're authentic.
Yeah, but do you really think it's gonna help the industry?
In one way or the other, what I can say, it has brought about a fact of union.
Yeah.
People were never together in masses or in numbers.
Mm.
Here you find that you can meet artists in under one umbrella.
Yeah.
And yeah, you can meet maybe uprising artists. You may meet the ones that have already made it, the legends, and you find that you can meet them under one umbrella. That is a positive. I mean, because. It wasn't there earlier on. Everyone was like, Uganda musicians are
very disorganized.
Disorganized. Yeah. But at least now you can find an organized umbrella of musicians.
Yeah.
And, you know, you address them. Or you get to...
You know, it's just that a few artists have a little one too. You know, the Gulu Saga and all that.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them just want to make money out of us. And
you know, there can be, a flat road. You always have to find bumps along the way. And... as long as you don't always dwell on the bumps, you consider the bigger picture. I believe these associations are good in one way or another, they'll streamline the information that we would want to convey to the government, and they will maybe act on it because of an unified voice.
Yeah, an organized.
Yeah, organized kind of system and setup.
Well, Zolanda, you've just said that, and it reminds me of something of seeing making rounds. Yeah. But thank goodness you're here to clarify. They always say, you know, if you get the message from the horse's mouth, that is when is.
Yeah,
you know,
I'll be the horse today.
Is it true that you had issues with Bebe Cool and you had put a lawsuit and something about a song campaign?
Yeah. We actually did talk about it. There's some things that we would really not actually talk about on TV because they are kind of like, you know, still legally, you know, constricted and all that. But I would say I don't have a problem with Mr. Sally Bebe Cool. Mm-hmm. He's a grown-up man. He's a legend in this business.
Yeah.
I appreciate his work and I also respect him. But with the business, we shall keep it behind the scenes and under the rug for now. I believe you understand
why. Yeah, I do.
But he's big up on herself, Bebe Cool.
Okay, so how about Swans Avenue though?
Hey, Swans Avenue, big up on herself, Swans Avenue. I don't have beef in my heart.
I see where you're going. You're really trying to, but...
Not really. I know what you want from
articles
me.
And bloggers people came through and said, oh my God, he left in a bad place and stuff like that.
Maybe if people... out there from the management.
There's no smoke without fire.
Talk about that, but from my side, from my side, we good, because we still actually mix and mingle with Benon. Yeah. Benon is my mentor.
Yeah.
He actually, you know, spiraled my journey into becoming what I am right about now, because, you know, he's the first guy who gave me a platform to, you know, start writing, because they accepted me to stay at Swans Avenue.
Yeah.
He was like, yo, you can come through every time. Mm. We think we can use you. So if somebody does that for you, why do you have even to cringe whenever, you know? So he's still my gang. I still write for them music.
Yeah.
I can't say, Winnie Nwaji is always on my case. We write music, we go to studio, we always, you know, vibe into the music. Julius, I don't have a problem with him. He's a businessman. I'm also a businessman. We're entrepreneurs, so we can always cross paths. So, sibali na ako bazibo kwa gamba, abantu bange. Yeah, part of my story.
Very interesting, by the way. But I'm actually happy to hear that. So, please, fans. You know, sometimes fans really start the beef.
They do. They do. They actually fuel it. Or they basi samunku.
So now that you guys know clearly, there's no beef. But well. I believe you are one of those artists who definitely plays an instrument. Do you play it?
Yeah, I actually play the keyboard.
The keyboard,
but I'm learning the guitar. I know that just like three chords.
Yeah.
But I believe by lockdown end, I'll be able to go on stage and showcase my guitar skills.
Yeah.
But for now, I can do a keyboard because that's what I use to produce the tracks. And I would also love the saxophone, you know it, that the likes of Jose Sax, those guys.
Yeah, they bring magic,
It's magical. Chitanda, Michael Chitanda is my OB. Tells me it's quite easy, but I feel like you can lose your breath.
Yes.
So, I play the keyboard, but... I'm learning more instruments. I can't, you know, life is a process and you have to, you know, endure the cost.
That is true. Well, you talked about, performance.
Yeah.
Let's just take it back. Let's imagine lockdown ain't on, you know.
Yeah.
Let's take back to those stages that you guys used to mash up,
Oh, man.
What has been your best? What has been your worst?
It's crazy,
in between there, what has been the craziest memory you remember?
Wow. Don't even remind me. Might bring a tear in my eye.
I know. It's quite sad.
It's quite sad that we can never we cannot appear in front of our fans no more for this period of time, legally, because I believe people are going and still doing that illegally.
They just show us the pictures after.
Maybe. Yeah. But some countries are actually open and people are performing again.
Yeah.
But right about now, the memories are really cool. The biggest stage I performed onto was a Busy Signal stage.
Yeah,
it was crazy.
Oh my
but even
God.
Before that, there's a time I joined Vampino on stage. Back then was Sean Paul.
Yes, yeah, I remember.
So it was crazy. So basically, man, and very many other stages, because you know, the audiences were lit, the buzz stages,
yeah.
You know, the you know, the those laughter, and there's a show, the Purple Party shows,
yeah, yeah.
You know, very very many stages were lit, and also our local whatever, what do they call them here in Lubiri,
yeah, yeah,
those chigundas,
chigundas.
So you go in to perform and you really
you see the entire crowd
you're like, yo, what am I doing? Yeah, so it used to be crazy. We miss that, but we give thanks. We know it will happen again.
What is your worst though?
My worst,
walked into a stage and no one knows you, or says, ooh,
actually my worst, they knew me,
yeah,
because I could say the times they didn't know me, I just enjoyed myself on stage and got them enjoying too.
Yeah.
But the time I feel like it was my worst, they pulled my coat. Oh, the kids, what the boys was buzzed, but yeah, were up at the rooftop of Garden City.
Yeah.
The kids pulled my coat and they actually took it.
Jesus.
But oh, I was going to fall in the crowd.
How much was that caught? Like,
man, it was crazy, because I was in, at the moment, I hadn't bought it actually. I was just going to buy it
from the
stylist.
Yeah.
So I had to pay the stylist around 200K for the court, because I saw it going, but I couldn't rescue it, because you can't start, you know, bickering with someone in the audience.
You know, they always say,
standing there, give me my, give me. So I just,
they always just say, when you're performing, flow, please don't fall on the crowd.
I just, you know how it happened? I leaned a little.
Yeah.
And the kid grabbed it.
Yeah.
And when the kids grabbed it, was, you know, like it was a fracas for it. So I just got out of it,
yeah,
and I kept on with the performance.
Yeah,
yeah, but that was maybe my worst experience. I left stage thinking, oh my God,
Jesus.
Now, what if I fail? What if, you know, everything would happen?
I know, it's always crazy with fans. Fans love too much. They just want to keep a little sweat, bit of the artist thing.
Though we were throwing stuff in them, you know, things, goodies, bandanas and all that, but they took the court, man.
Okay.
But it was crazy, because... yeah, you are fans and we love you. What we have is yours.
Yeah. Oh, okay. We're going to take more. So if lockdown was lifted right now, what is Zalanda going to do?
If lockdown was lifted back right about now, by all means, I'll travel. Mm. I'll travel for the tours that were scheduled.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, because they were just postponed.
Okay.
And you know, for the situation to get back to normalcy.
Mm.
But basically, more shows.
Yeah.
We would do that. But besides, the lockdown has actually showed us that we should digitize well and, you know, be able to earn from our music online.
Yeah.
Yeah, and not only the physical performances and shows, but online social media platforms, all the, you know, the YouTubes, the Spotifys, those platforms that pay artists, because they're out there to give you money.
That is
and,
true.
And, you know, we just have to, you know, embrace the new normal,
mm-hmm,
and have a good time with this life.
Well, you have a beautiful brain. All your writings are amazing.
I'll
so definitely I have to ask you, I have to really ask you this. What has been the most expensive piece for you? That you know, like this one, if they don't give me five mad down.
The music?
Yeah.
Actually, the one that I sold at the most was On Omar, not to Irene Natale. And I didn't actually expect she would give me the money, because there are better songs that she could have done and she could have paid for.
Yeah.
But basically, she gave me like five.
Damn.
But someone would say it's little. because people, you know, sell music.
Come on, Zolanda, it's your brain, man. Yeah, like, it is your brain. So that's how beautiful it is. So definitely. Well, you know what, Zolanda, you have some fresh stuff. So definitely, I want you to break it down for us. Yeah, These songs are amazing. We've already listened to them, and right here on the spotlight, a bit, we have even talked about them, you know, on the news. But now having you here on the red seat, break it down for us, like, a little bit.
Oh, yeah. I want to thank Face TV first and foremost for always, you know, trying to push our talent beyond borders, the young artists and the already established artists. The song Kweguya, in Kweguya, I believe some people have heard about it. Semanyilwa chimukwano Kweguya, nze Kweguya, nze nonyumongozo nyumongoze watali yado Kwegula, nze Kweguya. Yeah, don't believe it. Yeah, man, so that's it. That is the new one. Kweguya was produced by two producers. There's an audio producer called Ice.
Okay.
And Eliakis mixed and mastered it at Route Entertainment, where I be working from right about now.
Yeah.
It was done, of course, in COVID times. That's why, you know, it's special to me, you know, because not everyone is releasing work, a bunch of works and stuff like that. But we give thanks because we're able to do that. The guys who shot the video are called Rego. They were actually mentored by Aranea, because Aranea is actually the one who gave them to me.
Yeah.
So a big up on yourself, Aranea, for not always being selfish with your work. So he gave me, you know, DOPs to you to shoot for me a song.
Yeah.
So imagine when someone can do the job but gives you other people to do for you a job.
Yeah.
But respect, massive respect. Of course, big up on everyone that took part in it, the mother, Sean Canalo, works at you, Magic FM, the little actors, the extras, the kids, big up on yourselves, they work in some, man, it's crazy how you get to mix and mingle with many people in different art aspects in this game.
Yeah.
So we released that in Kweguya, and basically that's what it is about, love and, you know, getting you back to that hopeful kind of love, not us who are like, you know, still expecting to meet the real people.
Please, honey, jump into that.
But anyways, that is in Kweguya for you, and the video is now out, and we have actually a new audio that just dropped on all social media platforms and all streaming platforms called Tongo Vereda. You might find, you hear Tongo Vereda, I think I say don't follow me, but it's actually Tongo Vere, Tongo Vereda, Tongo Vereda, Ngamfunye Mukulinya, Tongo Vere, Tongo Vereda, Tongo Vereda, Ngamfunye Muzikuchi, Tongo Vere, Tongo Vereda, Tongo Vereda, Ngamfunye Mukulinya, Tongo Vere, Tongo Vereda, Tongo Vereda, Katinja Galakati, Titi, Katinja Galakati, Titi. Yeah, and you can find it on all the streaming platforms.
You are talented. You know, this is the way you just keep bringing it all, like, differently.
Yeah, thanks,
you know, 1 minute you're over the bar, then you're this side, and
put it over the bar. When you see Corey, tell your friend of F. Hey, yeah, you know how it is, man.
Well, we really want to support you. So please tell us where we have to go and get you. And not only that, we want to buy.
Yeah.
We don't want to download. We want to go and buy.
Yeah, man. Because
so
big up for the support. Social media, YouTube. I go by Zolanda TV.
Yeah.
Zolanda TV, the way you listen, you hear Zolanda, Zulanda, then TV.
Why TV
YouTube. Because it's my TV, man.
Okay.
That is the only, okay, you know, I hadn't transformed it to TV, but then somebody actually told me, put TV.
It's and channel.
I Googled it and it was fine, you know, to call it TV.
Yeah.
But Instagram, I'm on Zolandarian. On Zolanda, you just add R, R, R. and you add R-I-A-N, because my fans are called Zulandarians, actually. Okay. Big up on yourself, Zulandarians. They're always watching, they're always pushing me to do more. They're always, you know, on my case, you know, they love it. They love the vibes and, you know, big up on yourselves. They're all over the globe. I love them. Mm-hmm. And they love me too. And I believe it is still a young family. We can grow to a bigger family. Facebook, it is Zulanda.
Yeah.
Zulanda, just like Zulanda Music. I have a website, zulandamusic.com. You can support, there's merchandise too, you know. You can buy merchandise and stuff.
Yeah.
There's also stuff, freebies to be won.
Uh-huh.
I mean, so why not? People can always go there and find new content. And as for about the writing, we're always still, the writing office is still open, still, you know, provide those services, and they're actually quite good packages for the uprising artists. So the management knows better. But Apple Music, we have an account on Apple Music, on Spotify, on Boomplay, and Audio Mac, as Zulanda. You can find the music there. You can stream it, and you know, they put some dollars in our accounts, you know.
Well, I must say, you know the entire thing. Most fans don't know this. They had better go online. And
they should actually, get learning about it, because I got to learn about it when I had time, when I had surgery on my knee. I was bedridden for 7 months.
Wow.
So I got to learning the
What happened? But before, I know we're about to sign off, but I want to know what really happened.
I always just, you know, touch something a little, or flash a little light about it. I got an SCL. An SCL is kind of like an injury on a knee.
Oh.
It is on a ligament. It is called an acute something ligament, whatever, injury. So I got it, and they had to do surgery on me. We did at Kosu and Mulago.
Yeah.
And I was actually on clutches.
I'm praying by the time the lockdown is done, this leg had better jump. Yeah?
It is jumping right now, because we're doing the physiotherapy and all, and we're never stopping.
Yeah.
So I got learning about the online business or online side of music, because it is a business.
Yeah.
We're doing a business.
And
we're just
lots,
not doing
lots and lots
it for
of
the
money
passion.
There.
Yeah. Yeah, there's lots of money. That's why I'm wondering why the government isn't actually investing in the industry, giving it its own maybe even a ministry, because the people have done it, the likes of the Niger industry, the likes of the Tanzanian industry, that they can actually testify. It is quite a really, really multi-billion ministry or business. So when you get to learning that, you find that there's a lot of money we're leaving at the table right here in Uganda.
Well, but I think it's a good start.
It is a good start. People are actually jumping on things.
Is good.
Yeah, people are actually creating awareness, sensitization. In a while, we might be the pioneers, but the people in the future will enjoy. Yeah.
So, any message to all the Zulandarians?
Zulandarians. Yeah, man. Some fancy being called Zoo Gang, but it's also a faction.
Yeah.
In the Zulanda camp.
Yeah.
So Zulandarians, I love you so much. Thanks for always, you know, keeping my head up float. Besides that, my family, a support system, big up on yourselves. My clients, you know, you always keep the lights on. Big up on ourselves, and also all the producers that we've worked with, and all the musicians, the legends, the upcoming, and you know, the ones that are tussling it out. Big up on ourselves. Face TV viewers, love you so much.
We do, and you have a crazy fan base. Like, it's crazy. If we ain't playing Zulanda, they're like, yo, man, it's things that is music. I'm like,
Oh man. I can't say thank you enough. Words can't actually express this, but thanks for also, you know, calling me up, and I get myself running here, man.
Yeah, and talking to your fans, because they were in desperate need for you. We're like, you know,
definitely.
What?
Definitely. We had to catch up. We bridge the gap.
Yeah. So as we're saying our bye-byes, at least give us that, you know, that kafeel of one of those hot songs of yours, definitely. And then
I'll
you say goodbye.
I'll just dive into it.
Ndoza
wanku batatu putema kon my soul. Wanambisa kalamu ya kamwenyoko. Yawego.
Yeah.
Enkobe no yaluwele la mazimu benika. Omukade nakale suko baka kekake. Gatebina simuke bigambo bye wawandika. Kambi kopolole muka papula. Amanyi genonya yegwagalina muka batule. Omelo kulaba ngomobili ogumodolinga. Lukulaba kono vichu viti no surrender. Yeah. Simanyi lwachi mukwano nkweguya. Nze nkweguya. Zeno nyumungu zon nyumungu ze watali yado kwegula. Nze nkweguya. Yade mbalilila mbalilila na emu kwano nkweguya. Nze nkweguya.
Solanda, I am here.
Kalo
my name is not
zon
being
nyumungu
cool.
Za mumazigo wa getisa. Kori nze nkweguya. I tell ya.
Well, thanks for being part of the back end, ladies and gentlemen. Of course, you know
oh,
what?
Man.
I'm super lucky. Everyone wants to be in this place right now. So you have no idea.
You know how it
is. No. So having an artist say your name is quite amazing. So, man, thanks for coming through.
It's a pleasure.
And guys, let's
so
go
humbled.
Ahead, stream, do whatever you can. Zalana, Zalana, everywhere. But of course, you know what? We sign out.
Boom, boom, boom.